little difficulty in tracking. We do not have, off the top of my head, I want to say we have our collision rate per 1,000 is somewhere around 14. It's incredibly low. The topic that you brought to me was about car pedestrian collisions. I'm trying to give you some counts so you have an idea of where we're at. So in 2016, we had 36 car ped crashes and 28 car bike. In 2017, I dropped to 22 car ped and 14 car bicycle. So far in 2018, we only have 10 in total. We have 6 car ped and 4 car bike.
That's through March?
Through, yes, through the end of March. So we've dropped in half the number of collisions we've had. It's not uncommon at times in winter, but it will be our heavier months because of the volume of hours of darkness. That there's a noticeable increase in our hours of darkness. and with inclement weather, kind of magnifies that problem. And if people are, like a pretty common CC, out walking and wearing all black, it just magnifies the issue even more. And in particular, if they're not following traffic laws and they're jaywalking. So
annualized, that's right in the middle of the 2 years.
Yeah. So coming out of a heavy winter, yeah, we'll see you over the course of summer if it kind of continues on that way. I did bring a little chart if you'd like to see it.
Sure.
That mark right now is. So the yellow dots, this is the cumulative data from 2016 to current. The yellow dots are car ped, and the blue dots are car bicycle. So, not shouldn't be by shock that most of them are in the downtown core, because that's where we have most of our pedestrian traffic. 161st and is kind of a main thoroughfare closer to our bus lines as well, where we have more pedestrian drop off or people walking to the bikes, or sorry, to the buses. But as you can see, outside of the downtown area, it's a pretty dispersed populace.
Okay, so what I'm hearing is based on the information you have, that there's no emerging or growing anomaly, or you know what I'm trying to say. There's nothing, there's not a spike because we've changed our streets or the growth in population. Or,
no. This will be obviously the first summer that we're going to see downtown park with more private pedestrian traffic coming in. That area. So we'll deploy some more traffic resources in downtown on the weather days and weekends and that, just for high visibility with our biking.
Maybe we need a sensor if someone's wearing all black and has the earbuds in it. If there's a loudspeaker in there on their cell phone.
Better way to come in harm victim too.
Wearing black is appropriate if you're going to your funeral.
Well, it's, I mean, it's good news, but sorry. Does this change any of your, when you look at this data, does it change any, this is the kind of information that changes your enforcement focuses and locations.
So we have already have a high presence in the downtown area, in general. So we have a car that works downtown, and then now with the deployment of our bike team, so we have 4 bike officers that work in the downtown area as well. So just because we have a higher concentration of
right.
individuals, so we kind of deploy around calls for service, and we deploy our staff based around the high call line.
Okay, good. Anything else from anyone? Moving on.